We thank the Lord for giving us another opportunity to come together and meditate upon God's word. We have been meditating upon God's word, and God has been speaking to us about our progressive salvation. God has saved our spirit. He is saving our soul. The realm of our soul that consists of our intellect, our emotion, and our will. And we thank God that God is doing a work in the realm of our thoughts, our emotions, and our will.
Adu ko Ishwar bu thakar le ma du de ai koi gi lokshingi amadi ai koi gi ihul gi amadi aning bagi hoibo jaga singa sita thabok shubiri basi ki dama.
So our salvation is progressive. Our soul realm is being saved. And our body shall be redeemed. You know, and we thank God for this great economy of God, wherein God has purposed it so. That he may present us faultless in the day of the Lord in these three
realms.
And we thank God for all that God spoke to us in our previous meditations. We also heard very, very clearly that our mindset, we have grown up in a time where we have been so exposed to a man-centered gospel. Yes, we have grown up in that realm. In the time of this fifth gospel, where everything is centered around man, including salvation. But we see that everything is centered around God.
You know,
and so God has really helped us to see this salvation is centered in God. As we read in 2 Timothy 1:9, he saved us and called us according to his own purpose. It is his purpose. And it is according to that purpose God saved each one of us. So the salvation itself is in, you know, it is centered in God rather than in man. You know, so there is a work to be done in our thought realm. We have to be changed, we have to be saved in that realm. You know, in our minds, we have a lot of things which are not according to God's word. And we can only grow on into maturity when we are delivered from those concepts. We also heard that God bought us with a price. And we are his. It's not in terms of merely saying it. We have to live in the reality of that word. We also heard that the local church is to be filled with disciples. But we know that that's not the reality today. You know, we also saw very clearly this discipleship is not a matter of teaching, but it's a matter of a life of obedience. You know, it is a life that is formed by obedience and submission. You know, so we heard many wonderful principles from God's word. We also heard that the local church is a family of God. You know, let's just turn to that scripture once again before we move on today. The book of 2 Timothy and chapter 2. Thou therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus.
Yes,
and the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same commit thou unto faithful men. Who shall be also, who shall be able to teach others also. You know, that talks about discipleship. This is what the local church is to be. He says, that which I have given to you, those, the same thing, no change, no adding to it, the same thing commit thou unto faithful men, that they may also do the same thing. You know, this is how progression and growth happens in the local church. You know, so today what we have is the local churches, or the churches are sanctified country club. You know, so the kind of church we find today is like a club membership. You know, that's what we see today. But the Bible speaks about the household of God, the family of God. And we thank God for all that God spoke to us in the previous meditations. Now, the Lord is speaking this to us not just for information, not to have some kind of new understanding, but God is speaking this word to deliver us from the former way of thinking and living. The former way of thinking. That we may be delivered from a former way of thinking and living.
Yes.
Now, if that is not happening, then these Bible studies would mean nothing to us. You know, it is just a knowledge that we appreciate and then we are happy with. And we remain in the same bondage and mindset, and our life will never grow. There is nothing called progress in salvation in reality. We will continue to come to the local church and do whatever is necessary and go back. So there is no real progressive salvation in the realm of our mind at all. You know, so may God help us. We want to move on again in this meditation even today. You know, we heard from the book of 1 Thessalonians. We heard about Paul's the words of the Apostle Paul to the Thessalonian believers. Now, before I get into that meditation again today, I would like to touch upon that it's unfortunate today many churches remain in the realm of an organizational country club setup.
Yes.
You know,
club member naiba club ki mo matau da oiraga leri.
Now let me share this and then move on.
Ai dok chiraga ai chata jage.
Even during the times of restoration.
Ai shona chum bachin hanjalan bibagi matamadu daida.
In the times of those great movements of restoration,
I will tell na iho asukumba achumba anjalan bibagi matam da thokiba iho gi matam da.
The Lord restored certain truth that the church lost.
I will singlupna mang han kharwa adu gumba achumba singa do ishon amuka hana pibi ba
such as the restoration of faith unto God and our salvation by faith.
I will aikoi gi thajabagi ma pan aran khubam phangba haiba asigi matang da asigumba chumba anjalan diba matam
ta pina diba matam. The restoration of repentance and salvation.
Pukning hong bagi amadi aran puning hong dun aran khubam phangbagi asigumba makal gi restoration
asigumba makal gi
jan. I will baptize to bagi achumba singi marida.
The truth of sanctification.
And dopi bagi achumba sing adugi marida.
You know these precious truth which were lost, these truths were restored back to the
church. Hari bachu masinga se mang dun le rambata ki shorna amuka singlukta amuka hanjalan biba matamadu da.
Yes, though the truth was restored in those times,
hari matam singa du da chu masinga do hanjalan biram bani
one by one according to God's own mercy.
Soi minum sigi ma pana matang matang amama hanjalan biki bani.
We see that the church in those days, they were more a congregational
setup. You
know, just people congregating
in
thousands. You know, in those
revivals,
when great men like Luther and Wesley
Gumba
and George Whitefield,
Gumba
and many Charles Spurgeon
Gumba mayama
bana, you know, all these men, they preached to great number of congregations.
Hari bami oi khuding ma athoi bami oi singjin chau ma meeting sing da wa pau sa do,
and many people repented and came to the knowledge of Christ.
Mi kya na ma puning hong le haraga Christ ki gyan la ki.
Yes, and we know that that was a precious work of God, undoubtedly. But there was no true concept of the body, the church of the Lord, as a body of believers.
Yes.
There was no concept of the body of Christ.
Adi Christ ki singlup ki wakalon namal leramde mata madu daida Christ ki singlup ki wakalon.
People were members of a large congregation.
Me singa se yanda pak chauba mitin gi hoy bada warami.
But that is not what we see in the New Testament.
Adi koi madu nati ori bas se koi na bhav tari basi de.
You know, in the New Testament.
Ano bole na basi daida de.
We see members of the body of
Christ. Akon ori basi de Christ ki kayat sing have the
members. That is seen as the church.
Madu ko singlu poi na kauna pani singlu poi na.
That is what we see in the New Testament.
Ano bole na basi daida akon ori basi de madu ni.
You know, and so that we see that the born again believers,
mara madura na una pogla bathase ba amana,
those who repented and were baptized, they were added to the local churches, and they were
members
in an organic way. They were members of a local church. But what we see is, in the past, it was almost like an organizational way they were members of different church organizations. Yes. You know, and so we see that mindset in those years are still going on even today in majority of places.
Matamadu ta gi lerak po wakhalon singa do ayam bas mi sing da ayam basinglup sing da hojik phaw ba satha duna damak leri.
And we need to be delivered
from that. Adu wakhalon mi mam tin ba sing du gi wakhalon.
In those days the concept was more universal church.
Ari banu meeting matam sing to da de concept madur le ba wakal lon sing to apun ba gi singlu ki matang ba
ora. These great men talked about the church, it was more a universal church.
Ari ba athoi ba mi sing matam tu da le ba sing to chandok pa ngang ma matam da apun ba gi church ki matang da wakal lon do pi tu na ngang me.
You know, church as a universal church, a great congregation of people.
Aibadi yun apun magi church hara ga mi mam tin bado adu gi wakal onu de oirame.
You know, but that's not we see in the New
Testament.
And I know that the Lord was restoring the church.
You
know, and God has progressively brought the truth back to the people of God. With the baptism of the Holy Spirit. In the turn of the 20th century, there was further opening up of this truth. And during the days of the Lateran
revival,
you know, we see that a great understanding of the body of Christ came into being. So, my dear brothers and sisters, we need to understand God is restoring the primal, the initial, the original things which were lost to the church of Jesus Christ. Yes, he is restoring it. And he has to do it before the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. The heavens will not hold Jesus Christ. You know, when all these things are restored in the church. But until all these things are restored, the heavens will retain Christ. The Lord is coming back for a glorious bride. You know, a mature church. A glorious bride. So that's why God wants to bring this salvation into that realm of that fullness of our salvation. So may God help us to understand that the local church is to be filled with disciples. You know, church is not a cave that people come in on Sunday and hide themselves.
We heard that.
The church is the pillar and ground of the truth. You know, where the truth is lived and demonstrated. Oh, may God help us, brothers and sisters. You know, we have very less time on Wednesdays. And I want to, as much as possible, keep the time. You know, coming back to the book of Thessalonians. You know, we would read these verses. We saw that the church is a family. And we see Paul's expression in chapter 1 of 1 Thessalonians. You know, in verse 7 he says, but we were gentle among you even as a nurse or a mother so being affectionately desirous of you. Yes, we were willing to have imparted to you not the gospel of God only, but also our own souls, because you were dear unto us.
And he says in verse 9,
for ye remember, brethren, our labor and travail, for laboring night and day, because we would not be chargeable unto any of you. We preached unto you the gospel of God. You know, so we saw these scriptures very clearly. And we saw very clearly Paul's labor and, you know, and love for these saints.
Paul na ma na su nom du na ma isorgi miyo singa si bu nung sibiki ba sa ikon na si damay eksyeng na ure.
You know, many aspects of that labor and the love of Paul as a mother and as a concerned father, we saw very
clearly.
A father not only begets children, but he cares for them.
Now, I would like to
share a few more things today. And may God help us to understand this. The local church is a family of God. And the leadership has a great responsibility. And also the saints have a great responsibility. It's a matter of relationship. It's not a matter of an administrative, system. Now, Paul wrote this letter in the midst of many terrible situations. And Paul expresses his relationship with these saints. You know, the Apostle Paul was in
Thessalonica
only for a short time. You know, and yet that little time that he was in Thessalonica, it brought about a great stir. It created a great stir in Thessalonica. In Thessalonica, there was a great stir. Yes. And he had many enemies. They accused him of turning the world upside down.
Yes.
Turn with me to Acts chapter 17 and verse 6. And when they found them not, they drew Jason and certain brethren unto the rulers of the city, crying, "These that have turned the world upside down are come hither also." That is talking about Thessalonica.
Aduga makoi na makoi bu pangdrabada makoi na makoi na zason ta amasungka ato pa isine na ausing dagi sahar adu dagi angam basingi mama angda singduna laurak e taibang pan bu mathak makha olhan ba mi sing ado mapham asida desu lakle hai na pakon sa patara tarik tarukta.
Yes, they come here also. So we see that there were many enemies for the Apostle Paul right in Thessalonica. Yes. And that's one thing we need to understand. While Paul is writing this letter to the Thessalonians, we need to understand the background as well.
Yes.
Though he was there only for a short time, there were many who accused Paul of many things. No, when we read the same chapter and verse 4, for want of time, I wish I could read the whole verses from 1 to 4, but for want of time, I will read only verse
4. Yes.
Verse 17 and verse 4, 1 second. Chapter 17, Acts chapter 17 and verse 4. Some of the Jews who listened were persuaded. I'm reading from the New Living Translation to save time. Some of the Jews who listened were persuaded and joined Paul and Silas, along with many God-fearing Greek men and quite a few prominent women.
Aduga isorbu kiba Greek mayam amasung
yes
athoi bi nupi mayam po mayam na Paul amasung silaga
so we see that when Paul came to Thessalonica, you know, many Greek, as it says here, many God fearing Greeks
Paul ka silaga na asi ki Thessalonica da lako matamasi da adugumba Greek ki isor kiba mi ma kaya su aran kubam da
ya ki aran kubam khandi quite a few prominent women also believed in Jesus Christ and became part of the church in
Thessalonica. Yes.
Now let me just read this from the Message translation. It says, some of them were won over and joined the ranks with Paul and Silas. Among them, a great many God-fearing Greeks and a considerable number of women from aristocracy.
Mapa madu daida the Paul ga silaga da Thessalonica kya da Paul ga silaga na lakum matam da isor thaja isor ki bami hoy kya su yaure adu gi matakta adu gumba athoy ba class awang ba class ki nupi kya su yau ki.
You know, so we see that tremendous things happen as when Paul was there in this in Thessalonica.
Thessalonica kya da Paul na leba matam da asi gumba chaura ba thaba se thoki bani.
You know, so it's as it says here, they believed and they joined with Paul and
Silas.
You know, so things happened there which brought about a great stir and opposition, and Paul had many enemies, and enemies were there against the church and the saints in Thessalonica.
Paul mafa madu da thoki ba thau doga na isorgi miyo sing da har ba miyo sing se cha ona thabak tau ki thagot pi ki aduga Paul ga jelas ka ki mayo opta thesalana kya se da cha aldi yegna ba kya
now let us turn again to the book of first Thessalonians.
First Thessalonians ge like ta ko amuk tang yeng minase,
and we will turn again to chapter 1
pandu amada ko yeng minase.
Yes, and here we read Verse 8 and verse 9. And from you sounded out the word of the Lord, not only in Macedonia and Achaia, but also in every place your faith to God word is spread abroad, so that we need not to speak anything. You know, for they themselves shew of us what manner of entering we had unto you, and how ye turned to God from idols to serve the living God, living and true God. So from this scripture we understand one thing. You know, God's truth and word heralded all over Greece.
Ishwar ki achum vasi na Greece ki mafam kuding mak tasin thong na sandokhi ba koi na ure.
You know, in and through these believers and what God did there, many God-fearing Greeks and women from aristocracy turned to the living God. Ishwar
masi ki mioi sing asi ki punsida ki thabak tobi bamaram na thaja bami ka yada ki su adu duka awang ba class amadi chindong bi hai bati adu mathoi banu pi ka yasu yaro ki.
You know, and this is the background or the history of the church in Thessalonica. And now Paul had to leave that place. Because of all that opposition that happened, when you read chapter 17, you will come to know that. And then Paul had to write this letter to them. Well, there is no time to get into all the details, but and therefore in chapter 2, as we were reading, Paul says about how he is concerned about these believers. It's not only to be, you know, to beget them in Christ. Not only to beget them in Christ, but also to care for them. Now, that is what we see in the true
ministry.
Both locally and translocally.
No,
translocal means the traveling ministries like apostles and prophets. You know, we see that heart of a father and mother. We nursed you like a mother. And now he is concerned about as a father. So what I'm trying to share to us is, you know, in chapter 2, Paul gives the vindication of his conduct. In Thessalonica. You know, as we read through these verses in chapter 2 as well, the language of Paul conveys the impression that the enemies who were bitterly persecuting the saints were militantly engaged in a campaign to blacken the very character of the Apostle Paul. Gives this impression. And what is that impression? That these enemies, those who are against the church in Thessalonica, those who are against the Apostle Paul, they were bitterly persecuting the saints in Thessalonica and were militantly engaged, not only persecuting the saints in Thessalonica but militantly engaged in campaigning to blacken the character of the Apostle Paul.
Yes.
Amen. And this is the background. There are people against the church in Thessalonica, the saints. And also to blacken or to militantly campaign against the very character of Paul and blacken his character.
And therefore Paul says,
you have seen our life. Don't go about by hearing what others are saying about me. Don't be caught up with the atrocities that these people are bringing into your lives. Don't be troubled by
them.
You know, so he's telling them how they came to him. I mean, they came to them. Paul and Silas, how they came to them. And how God moved. And how that is going around in all Greece as a testimony.
Yes.
You know, so listen very carefully. And there were those who want to tarnish the very character of Paul. And so chapter 2 we see this. You know, Paul is trying to tell this disciples. He says, we have begotten you as a mother and we care for you like a mother. And we also are concerned about you as a father. And he says, our life and our behavior is before you. You know, so we, as we saw the last week, you know, what Paul is saying to them is, my very life itself is an evidence that I could not have been activated by motives of covetousness. I could not have done things there out of selfish gains. Like many others, philosophers and teachers of my times, or in other words, his times. Who have been, really a burden on the people. I was not like that. This is what Paul is trying to say in chapter 2. So may God help us to understand. In verse 9 he says, "For ye remember, brethren, our labor and travail." For laboring night and day, as we heard, he worked with his own hands. On the other side, there are those who are tarnishing his name and character. But he says, our toil and our labor. This is what he says. And again, as we turn to verse 10, and ye are witnesses, he talks about his very walk before men. Yes, he says, ye are witnesses. And God also. Oh no, that's something that really ministered to my heart. A spiritual leadership, whether local or translocal, as fathers, we must live so as an example. They are to be an example to the children. He is saying here, ye are witnesses.
Hallelujah.
What a tremendous thing it is. He is telling the saints in the local church here. He could tell them. He could call the Thessalonian believers as witnesses that his life had been exemplary in every way. How challenging it is for those who are in leadership. And how important it is for believers also to understand this. And that every believer is to be an example that way. That is the challenge in every local church. Yes. None of the members of the assembly could accuse Paul. Of being a poor example. Though there are those against him, militantly accusing him of his and blacken his character. Now this could be possible anytime. Not only in Paul's time, but also today. There could be those who are against the work of God, against the leadership, and could speak a lot of things. But he says to the Thessalonians, why we call you to be a witness of our life, you have seen us. Don't worry about what others are saying. You are witnesses of my life before you. Paul had that strength to call the local believers in Thessalonica to be witnesses of his life. While others were militantly accusing him of his character. And not only that, now another thing that really touches me is, again, ye are witnesses and God also. Yes, and God also. What a tremendous thing it is. You know, I would like to read that from the Amplified.
Amplified taki pazaningi.
Now the brethren at one. Oh, okay, sorry, I'm reading Acts. Yeah, sorry about it. You are witnesses, yes, and God also, how unworldly and upright and blameless was our behavior toward you believers who adhered to and trusted in and relied on our Lord Jesus Christ. Yes. Now I would like to read also from J.B. Phillips translation.
J.B. Phillips translation. Please pause again.
You yourselves are our witnesses, as is God, that we have been pure and honest and faultless toward every one of you. Hallelujah.
I could not say another Dharmasya Nama Sungamakpalaita Nathaza Vanakoi Narakta Tawa Karam Natakiva Hai Vanakoi Amasung Iswana Sakini.
Furthermore, God had witnessed Paul's life. In other words, and Paul was not afraid to call God as a witness. What a challenge that is. What a challenge that is for brethren in responsibility today. And I know that Paul was not a perfect man. He was moving on to that. And it's very clear in his letters. And yet, he was not afraid to call God a witness of his life. Because he lived a dedicated life. A dedicated life. What a challenge it is. Why today the church is, you know, the saints are languishing is because we are living in another realm. Living in languishing, what can we say?
Swantaba, ase kari maram gino, ekoi kanbo oidri bese kari gino, thawai gino.
Anybody help me about it for translation?
Swantaba kanmangam daba, languishing. Asi kari gino, aragadi ekoi thawai gino bese gado dalai tabagi ni, ato apam apam de hingbagi ni.
I'm not getting another word in English for that.
Taibangi oibam awang mat tawose de hingbagi maram na kan thari
bani kanmangam dri bani. We are not really coming into that progression and growth as local
churches. What's the word?
Durbal. So we are living in that realm and there is no real progress.
Yes.
Oh, may God help us to understand this. Paul calls the Lord to be a witness. He lived a dedicated life. Although there were many accusations against him, such as he was a burden for the believers, like many others,
had
taken their money.
You know,
all those accusations were thrown on him. Therefore he says, you are a witness. How I labor, how I work, as we heard last
week,
for I seek not yours but
you.
That was the dedication of Paul. But all these people were throwing mud on him. And also we see, it's very important as the family of God, as disciples in the local church, that we maintain this life in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
Now let me just read this again, and he says in verse 10, ye are witnesses and God also, how holily.
Holily,
that English word, you know, in other words, he says his life was holy.
Yes.
In the Greek, that word holy means carefully fulfill the duties God gives to a person.
Holy haiba adugi artha Greek taleri ba sidi ishona mi yamada pina bigra ba daito singa do yam section na soyhanda na ngak se laga chatpa do bo haibani.
Carefully fulfill the duties God gives to a person.
Ishona mi yamada sinaba daito pina biba da thabak singa do yam section na pangthok podo do bo haibani holy li haibani.
That's what that word holy there really
holy haiba wahi asina
ta
sena mafa madu da artha tori ba.
Carefully fulfill the duties God gives to a person.
Ishona mi mada pina biba thaudang sing ado yamna section na thunghanba pangthokpa du bhai bani.
Yes. So we see he is saying here, you are a witness and God also, how holily.
Nakoi nasu sakhi aduga.
How carefully I fulfill the duties God has given to me.
Ishona ingona pina bikra badai to sing ase kaya amuk section na aina pangthokki bage haina madu nakoi nasu amadi ishona su sakhi ni haibangam kibani pol.
Or many people, the leadership and the work of God is like a pastime work.
Mi kaya agida magta amadi luching ba kaya agida magta di ishona pina vibasing thabak sing ase adu gumba matam.
Everybody is starting a ministry today. Everybody has got their own churches today. It is very sad. We are living in a time. Every man is doing that which is right in his own eyes. It is very sad. And then we see on the other side, there are so many spiritual auditors. You know auditors? They tell you what is wrong, what is right. There are so many spiritual auditors. Never paid a price in life. Never lay down their lives for anything. It is very sad to see we are living in a time. They can talk all about what is wrong with the church, but they've never gone anywhere. Dear brothers and sisters, may God deliver us from this. God is not calling, God doesn't want us to be spiritual auditors. God has called us to a place of obedience and a living.
Where
in Paul says how carefully I fulfill the duties that God has given to me. Oh my God, help me is my cry. It is not a matter of how weak you are, how strong you are, but how willing you are in your heart to fulfill that which God gives to you.
Nangi na thamoi da ishona pina vikra vado kayamuk nang na pangthok chaning bage section na hai basini.
That's my cry before my God. Aigi
sorgi mangda ina kapsari bado maduni aigi tamak.
It's not a matter that you are perfect.
Masidi nang mapung pare hai bang ambudu natte nang mapung pare hai bagi wapam du natte.
It's not a matter you have a position. But are you willing to fulfill?
And
therefore Paul says, you have seen what we went through when we were in Thessalonica. You are witness. God is a witness. How carefully we were fulfilling the duties God gave to us.
Sona koi da pina viki badhi thai daito singdo koi na kaya amuk section na tau ki bano.
Great challenge for brethren and responsibility. Great responsibility for the saints of God. That we do not become spiritual auditors. But we grow into places of responsibility, fulfilling what God wants you to do as a member in the local church.
Please.
I'm sure God is speaking this word to help us as His people. To help us to come out of
ministry
and come into that great salvation that God has designed for His church in Jesus.
How holy.
We fulfill the duties God gave unto us. You know, this same word that is used here for holy is also used to reveal, to apply to the character of God, even in the book of Revelation. Same word.
Yes.
Yes, in Revelation chapter 15 verse 4 and Revelation chapter 16 verse 5. I'm not reading them for want of time.
Revelation 15 ki 4 aduga Revelation 16 ki 5 asida ida yauri.
You know, and here he says two words he uses. One is how holily and justly.
Kayamuk chengna kayamuk chumna hai nasida ida seasonary.
You know, the words he says that his life was also one of righteousness. His life was also righteous.
Yes.
You know, so that word righteous refers to his integrity. His uprightness of character. It refers to his integrity and his uprightness of character and behavior. Remember, this is not the righteousness of the law. Yes, as we read in the book of Philippians, chapter 3, just quickly, we will turn to Philippians chapter
3.
We have no time to read all the verses. We need to read from verse 4 to verse 10. For want of time, we will not read that. You know, we'll just read verse 6 onwards. Concerning zeal, persecuting the church, touching the righteousness which is in the law, blameless, but that things were gained to me. But what things were gained to me, those I counted loss for Christ. Yet doubtless, and I count all things but loss for excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them but dung, that I may win Christ and be found in Him, not having my own righteousness. My own righteousness, which is of the law. So when he says here, holily and, you know, and just or righteously, it is not talking about the righteousness of the law. But it talks about his integrity, uprightness of character, and behavior.
Yes.
In other words, but the practical righteousness that God works out in our lives. You know, when we yield ourselves to God. So listen carefully, but practical righteousness. Practical righteous living. integrity and uprightness in our character and behavior. As God works into our lives, as we yield ourselves to God. So it is not an imputed righteousness. Imputed. Yes. But it's an inwrought righteousness. A righteousness that is worked into our lives. As we yield ourselves to the Lord. That's what Paul is talking about here in Philippians chapter 3:4-10. Wherein he says in verse 9, but that which is through the faith.
Yes,
the righteousness which is of God by faith.
And said,
so that talks about a progressive moving on in that righteousness.
Yes.
I know the time has gone by, I'm going to close, but let me just close with this verse. So Paul says these words here. He says, holily and justly and unblameably. We have behaved ourselves among you that believe. You know, while there are enemies who are troubling the church of Jesus Christ in Thessalonica, and also tarnishing the very character of the Apostle Paul, he says, all that you are hearing, set aside. He says, I lived among you unblameable. What a courage Paul had to write this. That he could write to them and say that I lived unblameable. That word unblameable literally means not able to find fault.
Karimata maral phangbangam
da
bhaibani amakpalaita bhaibagi
arthadi. Remember, his enemies might accuse him. Remember, and that was happening. There were those who were against the Lord. They were persecuting the saints in Thessalonica. The local church was going through struggles. And the one who begotten them in Christ is no more with them. He had to hurriedly leave that place because of persecution. But he says, I've cared for you as a I've nourished you as a mother.
And
I'm caring you as a father even
now.
So the enemies might accuse him. But no one could ever prove their charges against Paul. And we turn to the book of Philippians. Chapter 2. Hallelujah. And verse 15. 14 and 15. This is what Paul writes to the church in
Philippi.
He says, do all things without murmuring and disputings. That ye may be blameless and harmless, the sons of God, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom ye shine as lights in the world.
Murmurum Sonadana Amasung Yerna Valaitana Tabakuding Magdao Masi Lamsat Patavamasung Saranana Chatpa Mirolgi Marakta Nakoi Amakpa Amasung Aswaiba Laitaba Isorgi Matasing Oigani Aduga Taibang Panda Nakoi Nana Makoigi Marakta Mangangum Nangali.
Like to read from J.B. Phillips.
J.B. Phillips, take it again.
Sorry, 1 second. Do all you have to do without grumbling or arguing, so that you may be God's children, blameless, sincere, and wholesome, living in a warped and diseased world, and shining there like lights in a dark place. Blameless, sincere, and wholesome.
Amak palaitana pukchel seng na. Soy palaitana.
Yes.
Amamba mapamda mangal gum
nangalo. I would like to read also from the Amplified.
Amplified teki supazage.
Yes. That you may show yourselves to be blameless.
Nakoi na samak na maral laitaba amak palaitaba
na utong na guileless
adu gumba
innocent and uncontaminated
aidi sokchen daba adu gumba oidana ba
children of God without blemish
aidi sogi macha sing maral laitaba sogi macha sing oina ba
faultless
aidi amak palaitaba oina na ba
unrebukable
aidi maral siba ya daba oina
in the midst of a crooked and wicked generation
asuma patra ba mirol sigi mama ang sidaida marakida
spiritually perverted
awaigi oina serana ra ba
and perverse
aidi ona taina ra ba serana ra ba
among whom
machat patra ba sing
you are seen as a bright light
na koi ase angarang ba mangalo ina ubai anana
ba stars or beacons shining out clearly in the dark
aidi amamba taibang asidaida lang nangali bathawan michakum nangan bo oina na bagidama
I would like to close here today. Many more things to share. But let me say one thing. May God help us that we may be delivered from every other mindset. You know, the local churches in every place will have to be a place of true discipleship. That it's a spiritual family. The responsibility of the local ministries and the translocal ministries and also the responsibility of the saints are very, very important.
Aduga malamdam lamdam dal leiba lidlu singba singi aduga mafam kaya chatna tauribal thagol tauriba lidlu singba singi damakta masiki daito se ammaru oibani.
You know, carefully fulfilling the duties God gives us as leaders and as saints. In the local
singlup sing lamdam lamdam da leiba singlup sing asida da iswargi mi oina ma di iswargi daito puba luchingba oina iswarna sinagra bathabak sing ase yam section na toba yam na pangtok padarkar oi
there will be those who are
when ningsing bio madudi maral sibami sing leiga
they will do be militant to tarnish and go against what God is doing and also about your own behavior
na koina samaki lamsat chajat aduga tasena iswarna thabak toriba sing ase bo masigi mangala sibo mamsil lana ba sathi na madugi mayok ta thabak subo mi sing laigani
and Paul did not succumb to this
bo hari basing asina mai thiba pibanga mankide
he says I call you to be witness and I call God to be my
adu bo pol na ki bodina koina aigi sakhi ne dukai iswar mamna chu aigi sakhi ni hai bangam ki bani
era chau ba thabak in my life afresh and this is my prayer Lord help me to carefully fulfill
the duties
that you will give me you have given and you will give me
adu gaina ta jai ba prarthana di iswar na nai ngonda pina bigada ba ma di pina bi khra ba thaudang si thaudang sing ase kai amuk chek chen na aina pangthok cha bada nahak na paisor
tengang
bi wa bisa ki prarthana ni
to walk in that integrity and uprightness.
Madugi dharma chenna pukchel sengna chapyungna chachawna nabagidamakta.
That I would allow God to bring about that inward righteousness as I yield to His will.
Abide aina maake waisinga sida pishin jabamatamda iswarna madugi dharma chenma do agi punchida mana sobiraga oirakpa yana nabagidamakta isinawsing.
In the midst of many things happening, shall you all stand
up
and look to the Lord in prayer? We request Jomon to come forward and close with a word of prayer.
Heavenly Father, we thank you, we bless you for this evening. Lord, you have called us to be witnesses of your kingdom on this earth. A great challenge before us. Day by day we see the fall of man increasing, but you have called us into this lively hope. You have given us a responsibility and a call over our lives, that we are those who need to bear the testimony of that kingdom on this earth. Unto that end, Lord, we bring our lives to you this evening. Lord, we are called to be witnesses of your kingdom. Lord, what a great calling you have called us into. This is not man's agenda or man's propagation, Lord, but this is your kingdom. We are called on this earth to be those who would bear, Lord, witness of that heavenly kingdom, Lord Father. We bring our lives to you this night. Help us, Lord, bring us to a place of obedience. It's not in our strength, but are we willing? Lord, you have help us, Lord, that we would be those who would be willing to go on to that end where you have called us into. We bring our lives to thee. In Jesus' most precious name we pray. Amen.